Hi, and thank you for joining me for another short talk. And friends, today I want to quickly speak about healings, but specifically I want to speak to those who use healings or miracles as a way of justifying religion. In other words, I would say that the vast majority out there, actually a huge, huge segment of the population, actually validates what religion is true for them on what sign or wonder is performed in the name of that religion. Or worse, a dream that they may have had, that they saw Muhammad or Jesus, or even in the Jewish world, that they may have saw the Rashbi, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, and thus, this confirmed it for them. And this, like I said, goes for Jewish groups as well. Friends, today, it's time to really put this all in perspective. I'm going to attempt to explain this whole ridiculous phenomenon with where our outlook should start and end, and that is in the Almighty's Torah. Friends, the Torah tells us in Parashat Vayera that the Almighty, for some unknown reason, tells Moshe and Aaron to present themselves before Paro and throw their staff onto the ground so that it can become a reptile, or we translate that word today as a snake. But anyways, friends, we see that in this case, Aaron obeys, throws his staff, and it becomes a snake. But then, what do we see? We see that Paro's men do the exact same miracle. And then we see Aaron's snake swallow up the other two snakes. Fine, that's the narrative. And friends, this here is a Torah's answer to all of you who base your faith on healings or miracles. And that's that the reason that the Almighty told His servants to make a snake before Paro was only so that Paro could duplicate the miracle. Why? Because by duplicating it, they were canceling out their own power, teaching that anything that can be duplicated is not proof for anything, completely confirming to all those in Paro's court, in front of Paro, who himself was a god to them, the fact that they were only mortals, and in no way any different than Moses and his brothers, two individuals who never claimed anything other than being spokesmen for the Almighty. Why? Again, because a sign cannot be a proof if it can be duplicated, which is why, following this event, the Almighty then performed miracles that could not be duplicated. In other words, you cannot be a god if you bleed, as we saw in that awesome 300 movie. But most importantly, to every Christian listening, that Paro could not be a god if his own son could die, which the text states that he did die. Not to mention that the Torah itself specifically tells us not to trust in miracles. And this is really where we could and should be thanking YouTube. Why? Because before YouTube, every religion out there or every church out there could claim to be the only group to perform certain miracles without competitors, right? Because people didn't know any better. And because they didn't know any better, they based their faith on this church or movement or religion, but no longer, not with YouTube, friends. Why? Because now we can search to see what the Hindus are doing, the Muslims are doing, the Catholics are doing, even the atheists are doing. Which is why now it's a time to wake up to the fact that because YouTube, you are able to see virtually every other religion on this planet also performing these healings and exorcisms. In other words, they're completely washing out the fact that God would ever expect you to validate what you believe on any of this. As a matter of fact, there's a man by the name of The Amazing Randy that for the last 30 years has made a $1 million challenge to anyone who claims to be able to heal anyone on command in the name of anything. Not people who claim to have been healed, but just one man and one sick person of his choosing. And you know what? Till today, no one has ever claimed that $1 million. My friends, it's time to return to what cannot be forged and cannot be manipulated. And those are the words and the ideas that work in our God's Torah to better this world. So, what am I telling you? I'm telling you, friends, do not rely in miracles. Why? Because others are doing the same miracles in the name of their movement, whether it's the shamans, the Mormons, the Muslims, the Hindus, the Kabbalists, the Catholics, the Wiccans, the acupuncturists, heck, even the atheists. They all perform similar wonders in the names of their causes. Oh, but yours is true, and what they do is under the power of the devil? Honestly, friends. And another phenomenon that I wanted to touch on is this whole falling or being slain under the spirit. And it's really so funny on how in the Christian world, preachers are gauged as holy based on how many people he or she can knock on the floor by what they claim is the power of the Holy Spirit. Friends, what if I told you that the idea of slaying people in the spirit, which was first seen about 150 years ago in the early American revivals, that this practice of slaying people in the spirit only became popular because of a church in Toronto in the early 1990s. Now, this church did not only popularize being slain in the spirit, but also animal manifestations, which is like people barking like dogs and clucking like chickens and drunkenness in the supposed spirit and a few other visually unappealing spectacles. Now, let's just stop for a moment and think. Why would a good God who has demonstrated his love and will by the actions he expects from us in Torah, which again were meant to separate us from the animal and to abolish drunkenness, why would he then expect us to buy this? Right, the same God who has shown us through the example of Nadav and Avihu that we can't just do what we want in his name and expect approval. Why would this God now throw people to the ground and have them crawling on all fours, yelling, twitching, and blurting out phrases in unintelligible languages? Friends, our God does not change, and this is not from our God.
You've got cancer of the stomach? Are you ready for God to burn that cancer out? Here it goes in the mighty. Devil, back off. Back off, devil! Woo! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
You really believe you're healed?
Yes.
You think your cancers are gone now?
Yes, I believe that, because God never lies, and we stand in his word. Praise the Lord.
I tell you, from now on, you're going to have a song of victory in your heart. News from Charles. Before everything is over, I'll tell you, he's going to be completely delivered because of your prayers, because of your faith. Here it comes, complete healing in Jesus. Ooh, mighty name right now.
Hello, Petey. Can you hear me? If you can't, you're in trouble.
Popoff was being prompted by his wife through a wireless earpiece.
John?
Dearie Johnson.
She'd gotten her information from prayer cards filled out by the faithful before the show began.
She's about to get rid of the walker.
You want to get rid of this walker, sister? Oh, glory. How long have you been walking on
this? Now, what does this really resemble? Friends, it resembles all the practices described in ancient Gnosticism as well as other Eastern religions, like the awakening of the chakra in Hinduism, which is tied into many Hindu yoga techniques, as well as many other belief systems of the past. Now, I'm not silly enough to call it evil forces or in any way demonic, but rather a very, very common form of hypnosis, which, as we can see today, again, with YouTube, has even been able to get one to believe that they are an animal or in door operations without anesthesia, as well as overcoming serious illnesses. In other words, meaning that virtually every ancient belief and even modern New Age belief has been able to perform similar supposed miracles by getting the human mind and body to react in a certain way, this means that it really doesn't matter who the preacher is or what religion he's preaching. If you're convinced enough, you will see things that we do not consider common happen. However, the Torah itself gives a different challenge. What does it say? The Torah tells us that you, by keeping these mitzvot, these commandments that the Almighty instructs us to keep, that the nations of the world would say, what a wise, understanding, and discerning people. In other words, it's not because of signs and supposed wonders. Why? Because, like we said, everyone could do these. But what they can't do is duplicate a set of instructions that had and still have the power to better this world, which is why Chazal famously state that if they tell you that there is wisdom among the nations, believe them. But if they tell you that there is Torah among the nations, do not believe them. In other words, what the world cannot duplicate is Torah. So your question should be, why would something that really comes from God ever try? So you want proof that you're in the correct belief system? Do you want to know you're walking in the same path laid down by the Creator in the Hebrew Scriptures? Friends, it's easy to know, and that's if your belief and faith in Him starts and ends with His instructions, i.e. His Torah, our individual moral training guide on bettering this world. Friends, this is all the proof that you need. Which if you took anything I just said to heart, friends, you would never belong to any belief system which claimed that an illiterate man in a cave was made to read some book, or that because someone rose from the dead, or even because the Torah claims that the Almighty appeared before a nation on Mount Sinai. Again, friends, because all this could be made up and you wouldn't be able to say otherwise. No, friends, you should follow our Creator based on the validity of instructions that work. And then and only then can you really see what no one else has been able to fake since creation, and that is a world moving towards peace. So if your church or synagogue is all fluff, just a lot of praise and worship, dancing and falling on the ground, but no Torah, friends, you are in the wrong place. If your church or synagogue feels that it must tie everything it teaches into some mediator to act like some sort of human blood atonement for your actions, you, my friends, are in the wrong place. A reliable set of instructions with the goal of physically bettering humanity, that is what our Creator gave us, and that is Torah Judaism. Friends, for more information on everything Jewish, please visit bejewish.org. Thank you.